where their leadership are present with us today, tonight. And today we had a wonderful event, discussion, and I would like to exchange with you what we had in this discussion. And we'll have six of the national organizations which had in mind, in heart, in plans, the what the Muslim community in the states need. And all of them are well known. We'll have MAS, the Muslim American Society, represented by its executive director, Brother Hussam Al-Jabri, and the national president for MAS sends you, Dr. Ahmed Bindari, sends you his greetings, and he had to leave. We have from the ICNA Islamic Circle of North America, the co-sponsor of the sponsor of the event, Dr. Zahid Bukhari, and he is the national president for ICNA. We'll have from the ISNA Islamic Society of North America, the Secretary General, Brother Safa Zarzur, and we'll have from the Council of American Islamic Relations, Brother we'll have its Executive Director, Brother Nihad Awad, with us, and we'll have from the American Muslim of Palestine AMP, Dr. Hatem Bazian, the chairman of the board of the AMP, and we'll have from the American Muslim Task Force, the executive director, national executive director, Brother Muhammad Salim Akhtar. These are the six of the national organizations in the States, and this is an effort that we try to present one of the sides for lend a hand, help light the way, which is the theme of the convention, on a level of the national leadership of the Muslim American community. Today we had a good discussion for what's needed for the development of the Muslim community in the States. And we extended the invitation for a list of 25 of the national organizations in the States, and many of them showed their interest but the inability to attend this meeting. And inshallah, we will have another meetings coming soon, inshallah, between these wonderful, talented, skillful leaders whom we trust in their deen, in their mind, in their sincerity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in that, but we believe in their sincerity, in their deen, in their talents, and we are very much hopeful that inshallah these efforts will bring a goodness for the Muslim community in the States. We'll give a chance for every one of the six, our six leaders, to address the congregation with what their organization has in mind for the consolidation of the concerns, the interests of the Muslim community in the States. We'll start, inshallah, with the executive director of the Muslim American Society, Brother Hussam Al-Jabri, please.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I hope everybody enjoyed and benefited, and much more importantly is energized in order to go back to our communities and deliver. There is a lot that is riding on our backs as Muslim Americans. There is a lot that America expects from us. There is a lot that our Muslim Ummah expects from us as Muslims, as Muslim Americans. And there is a lot that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects from us. When He says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ وَلْتَكُنْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٍ. This is our duty and our challenge and in fact our opportunity. And there is no better place in the world today that is more ripe and more available and more waiting and more willing to understand and digest and engage with the Muslims like America. We know that, especially as immigrants who have seen other places other than America, we know that this is a beautiful place. And there is a place willing and open and ready to hear about Islam. But we have to say our message. We have to define ourselves. We have to tell America and say who we are and not being defined by others who may be antagonistic to our religion. To do that, you have a role. Every individual has a role. Every Muslim has a role. 6 million are only 2% or so of the population. Our local organizations have a role. Our national organizations have a role. And you know, there are many challenges that are facing us, especially after 9/11. Many, Islamophobia and the pressure that is on us. We're a young community. We haven't had the centuries that other communities have to digest and understand America. Two-thirds of our community are immigrant or children of immigrant that are still making sense of what does it mean to be home in America. We're young. And we're learning, and our institutions are not as big and capable as other institutions. But that's the beauty of the challenge. We're setting the foundation. We are setting the foundation. And right now, there is more willingness and more need for the Muslim organization, national and local, to come together and to recognize that we can no longer be working as islands. And even though this is applicable to the national organizations, it starts from you. You have to realize that our strength is in being Muslim Americans. And we have to reach out beyond our ethnic boundaries, beyond our comfort zones, within the other communities and ethnicities in our community, as well as reaching out to the larger society. Because that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects from us. And give me a better community situated better than the American Muslim community. Yes, we're only 6 million, but these 6 million are not found anywhere else in the world. Give me 6 million that are as educated, as resourceful, as capable, and as strong. We can do it. And America is waiting for us. It's asking, what is Islam about? And America is different than Europe. Europe made up its mind about Islam centuries ago. They have been dealing with Muslims ever since the Crusades. But America is new, 200 years old. It's welcoming and opening its arms to all the immigrants and everybody else. It's our turn to come together and make that happen. I'm happy that I am starting to see this happen on a national level. Some of it is because we have to, because we're recognizing that no longer can ISNA do it alone, and MAS do it alone, and CARE do it alone, and ICNA do it alone, and everybody else in the digital soup do it alone. We have to come together. It's a mandate from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is what you expect from us. And I ask you to hold our feet to the fire. Hold our feet locally and nationally to the fire. And ask us, what are you delivering? Don't just be happy with one big, great conference that has 5,000 or 25,000. Why can't we have conferences that have 500,000, that reach out even beyond the Muslim community and have non-Muslims who come and participate and engage with us so that we can solve our community's problem? And our community is no longer just the Muslim community. Our community is our country, is our larger society where we live and where we behave. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring our hearts together, to enable us as organizations and as individuals, local and national, to go outside our comfort zone, come together, fulfill the mandate of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be united and to meet Allah's expectation, meet our country's expectation, and meet the expectation of our community. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
MashaAllah, very good time management. Exactly 5 minutes. My pleasure to introduce Dr. Zahid Bukhari. Dr. Zahid Bukhari is a national president for the Islamic Circle of North America to address us.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulihil Kareem. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear leaders of the community and brothers and sisters, let me first congratulate to MAS and ICNA brothers who organized this wonderful convention and congratulate to you all these participants